You are now listening to the West Side of THA AfterParty.com.
Yo, 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 it's your boy Sneaky from R&R, recognition and respect. Tune in every Monday from 8 to 9 to catch up with me and my adventures and hear from my guests ranging from artists to entrepreneurs and much, much more. Catch us every Monday of the week on the West Side of the After Party. See you at the party, y'all. What's up, party people? Thank you for tuning in to Recognition and Respect with me, Sneaky. Coming to you from Los Angeles on the west side of the After Party. We finally had like a legit beautiful LA day today. I was wearing shorts. The sun was out. It was fresh. It was nice. My nephew was running around playing with toys. It was just a perfect day. I got a guest today. We're about to bring him in right now. But first, let me talk about my sponsors. As always, this show is brought to you by Dewdrop Delights, home of the Wake and Bake Bar, a THC-infused breakfast bar with oats, nuts, dried fruit, and chocolate. Great in the morning with coffee or tea, perfect for on-the-go snack and pick-me-up. Comes in four different flavors. Me, personally, I'm not a huge edible guy, but I smoke hella heavy. So I'll take the bar and I'll like separate it into threes. And so every morning, I'll just take like a third and then blaze it, and I feel like that combination helps me save my herb but still like have a long lasting high throughout the day. So shout out Dewdrop Delights for keeping me high. Appreciate you. Super important in these days, high stress environment, you know what I'm saying, we live out here. New sponsor, La Clica Podcast. Our last guest are now sponsoring Recognition and Respect, bringing it to you on Spotify. So Spotify just bought up a bunch of podcasting space, and it was imperative for me to get my podcast out there. So I teamed up with La Clica, so you can now find Recognition and Respect under La Clica Podcast on Spotify. So that's dope. We're going to be getting out all the new episodes, starting with the swap cast we did with Rick. And going forward, all the new episodes, you'll be able to listen to them on Spotify, bringing it to you all the places where you're at. I got an update for Border X Brewing. We're going to finally have some IPAs in the brewery. We're going to be pouring the Chiquitín Session IPA. And they're going to be bringing, for the first time ever, to the Bell location, the Yuzu Tang collab with Sushi Deli, San Diego. It's a lemon-infused IPA. So starting Thursdays, we're going to have more hats, more shirts, and two IPAs that are going to be pouring. So we'll see you 4 o'clock Thursday night for Latin Jazz. I'll be there. I'll actually be there this whole weekend. I don't have any other gigs booked as of right now, so I'll be at Border X helping out with sound, being a host, hooking you up with free beers, so make sure to come through. David, if you're listening, I'm just kidding. Nah, man, that's what we do, community. Every time I'm there, I always run into people I know. Like, I was there on Sunday, and I legit ran to like 10 or 15 people that I knew from the hood, the community, homies, older brothers, people with their kids. It's just super dope vibes in there. So I'm happy to be part of it. If you haven't come, check it out. I will be posting a recap video of the grand opening this week sometime to promote our Thursday through Sunday schedule. So hope to see you out sometime this weekend. Last but definitely not least, the Midnight Motives, their album Visions, available on iTunes, Spotify, everywhere music is at. We just rocked a show at the Catch One, so we'll just jump into Adventure Time. It was a dope week. The Society, we launched our new monthly with the Ill Spot, Face, Baseline Events, DJ Def Jeff. It was dope, considering we didn't have too much promo, and USC was on spring break, so we didn't really have that like promotional pool. We were still able to get a good amount of people in there. We pulled numbers, we'll be getting our percentage. So we're going to be bringing it back next month. Look forward for the lineup. We're actually going to get it out quicker and really go hard in our promo. We're expecting to be able to like have a dope Thursday night event. Every second Thursday, the Society, Miles Bar, Hill Street, South LA, baby, South Central. So come out, come to the hood. Then we did the Catch one on Friday. It was dope. The Paranoias, Evil Corps, thank you for bringing me out. Fuck, the show was dope. These fools are like superstars now. They got to do like an hour and 20 minute set, and they were just like wasted and talking to the fans, taking requests. It was just hella dope, hella dope. And then I did Indy for St. Patty's Day. And after that, since they closed early, went to Echo, Mexico, got to catch EOTR and Gavlin and Spec, and just had fucking dope night for hip-hop. Sesh was running sounds. Freaking my homie Face and Barlos performed. I didn't get to see the performance. They went on early, but I still got to roll up, and we partied. And then I went back to the studio and slept there because, you know, I'm ratchet. So, and then I had a Border X Sunday, ceviche, micheladas, freaking... What was it? Chicano Soul. It was a bunch of vinyl DJs playing like Chicano oldies, lowrider tunes. Super dope vibes. I was hella stoned. I'm telling you, I love being in that space. It's very like, feels like fam, you know? Feels like fam. So that's it for the Adventure Time. Like I said, Border X this week, Thursday through Sunday. Thursday and Friday, tap room is open 4 to 11, and Saturday, Sunday, it's opens at noon. So come out, try the new IPAs that are going to be on tap, enjoy the food. And right now, I'm going to go to a quick break. I know I got Poetic Force in the studio, so we're going to bring homie in right now and start our conversation. So Brittany, take us to break. We'll be right back. Mwah.
Yeah, 3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just
3 feet,
3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just 3 feet, I'm just,
yeah,
3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just,
yeah,
3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just
in the game, in the game.
3 feet, I'm just,
yeah. So peace to all the masterminds. Overdosing on motivation, discounting time. I'm steady focused and patiently waiting for the climb. You're feeling hopeless, well God may lose a mind. It's been crazy these 25 years counting blessings. Complaining I'm heavenly, waiting for the stressing. Without the bottom there's no other place to learn your lessons. So play with fire, get burned like a smoking session. To pass the blunt I'm getting faded like your dress attire. I promised everybody all about these rap desires. I kept the grinding and rhyming, feeding this rap messiah. I'm dropping bombs on every song until you catch a fire. So yo, yeah. And we riding around town, we about 3 deep. Got the homies with me, and we knocking on these beats. And I'm stuck in the game, about knee deep. I'm just
3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just 3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just
in the game, about knee deep. I'm a few steps away, about
3 feet, I'm just 3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just 3 feet, 3 feet, I'm just
in the game, about knee deep. I'm a few steps away, about 3 feet, I'm just.
Yo, what's up, man? Welcome back. We're here, Recognition and Respect on the west side of the after party. I got my guest, Poetic Force.
Yeah, what's up? What's up? Nice to see you.
How you doing, brother?
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, man.
Yes.
So let's just jump in this. Tell the people who you are and
for
what
sure.
you do, as literal as metaphorical.
Yeah.
As you
are. My name is Poetic Force, representing from West Covina, California. Hey, from the West Coast. I'm a musician, hip hop artist, recording artist, producer, engineer, creative. And just overall, good human being, man. You know, just trying to spread the dream and spread the message.
I like that.
Yeah.
So how long have you been doing music? And like, what? What's like your first memory of like music? How long, how far back does it go?
It goes back pretty far, you know, within my family. My dad plays guitar, drums. And so when I was a kid, I've always loved music.
And it's been, you've been surrounded by it.
Yep, surrounded by it.
Already,
yep. Pops got me a drum set when I was young, when I was a kid. So started with that and picked up the guitar a little bit and started writing rhymes and getting into hip hop more in high school.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Going through life.
Teenage.
Yep. Situations.
Of LA
yep.
And all that.
Skateboarding. So that really.
So have you always made your own beats, or is that like a new thing?
No, that's a new thing, man.
So I just like incorporating all the old stuff.
Yeah. That's all the old stuff, and now I kind of stepped out of my comfort zone and wanted to try new things. started making beats, started engineering more, writing more like hooks and melodies. Instead of just rap and bars.
Kind of what you have to do, like evolve as an artist and kind of stretch your boundaries.
Exactly. And play more instruments too. I stopped playing drums, when I was a kid, but then I recently just picked up the keyboard and the guitar again, so it's good to get back in that.
Yeah,
you know
you're
what
like
I mean?
Flexing the muscle. You're working out.
Yep, instrumentals and I love that stuff, man. So,
all right, that's dope.
Hell yeah.
So we kind of haven't seen each other in a long time,
right? Yeah,
I think 7 years. About like when I dropped the record that we did.
The show.
Well, before that.
Yep.
Yeah, it's been since me and Renee went to college together, basically.
Wow.
If you think about it, right?
Yep.
So I'm kind of curious.
Yeah.
What's been going on in these last years? I know you're going to school for recording or something like that. And you're working in studios.
Yep.
And so just fill us in.
Yeah, I was last 7 years, man. It's been a lot. But,
dude, seriously.
Right. Man, your dreadlocks have gone too.
These are not even the same ones, dog.
Wow, that's
crazy,
bro.
Dog. That's how long
I love growing like that. Yeah, same with me. My hair too is different. I cut all my hair off. I was going to school for a little bit. Got into recording arts, engineering. Went to the LA Film School.
Okay.
So it was pretty dope. And then got out of there, started interning at a studio for a while.
Did you finish the program? You certified?
Yeah, finished the program, graduated. Not to brag, but 4.0.
Woo!
Yeah.
Hey, you got flexed on them.
So in high school and junior high, I wasn't so much involved in school. So this was something I loved to do. So 4.0 was I just wanted to know everything, So that was just awesome for me, accomplishment.
And did it change your music, how you work with music?
For sure, how I hear music now.
Right.
Yeah, I still want to get better, of course, at mixing and engineering and stuff. But just hearing music sonically now is totally in a whole new level for me.
Different experience now.
Listening to other music and genres. That shit is tight, man.
Does it bug with you sometimes?
Because you can't just listen to something. It does. Always.
You're always hearing the production. Mm-hmm. Like, how much reverb is on that? Mm-hmm. What do they do with that?
Yep,
that
the panning.
They did that shit backwards, little sample cut. Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes. I know what you mean. It's I can't listen to it normal. That's a trip. I never really thought of that. But.
Yeah, well, I mean, I feel like that. I can't even go to shows. I DJ too, so I'll be hearing DJs, and I'm like, all right, what's he doing? Speeding up the track
crazy.
Right here. He's about to mix. All right, I hear.
I love that.
I'm always learning. I'm always studying.
He's about to do already.
Yeah. So it's and then I'll tell my homies, and they're not paying attention. So I'm fucking up the show for them. Yo, man, you saw that? I have no idea
what you're talking about. Yeah, it's tight though. But yeah, same here. It's just music is just I love it, man. And not just so much of I love hip hop. Hip hop is in my blood.
Of course, forever. Right.
But just starting to listening to other things and other genres, I think that's important as an artist, because you learn and you get to grow and you get to figure out new things about yourself, what you couldn't do.
Right.
I love trying new things, and I think that's how it happened. I started not getting bored, not like that, but just more of
hungry for something new.
Exactly, bro. I just wanted a new energy, just be around something new. So I just falling in love with music more and more
in a different way,
dude,
right?
Yeah, it's
crazy.
Well,
I feel like that happens. I feel like once you start playing instruments, and then you hear how those instruments are used in other genres, that's what you relate to, right?
Yes, of
it's
course.
When you're just rapping,
yeah.
If someone's not rapping in another genre, then how what are you connecting to, right?
True.
But now you're playing instruments.
Do you play instruments?
I play the trumpet. I play little keys, and I know a little bit of drums. I could hold a beat for you. I can hold 16 bars.
Yeah, I am too. Yeah, I wasn't real intricate with it. I just like basic beats and.
Nah, and I think
the trumpet's cool though. That's freaking awesome.
Honestly, I'm trying to get back into that.
That's
it's something
dope.
That I don't fuck with as much, but
you
I still
do it
have
live.
It. Yeah.
You could start bringing that into your shows.
Mm-hmm. Or even just start sampling myself so I don't have to clear shit,
Yeah, just on my new album, I have a great friend of mine. His name is Jacob. Sorry about that. Jacob Hearing, and he played the trombone.
Okay.
So on that song, 3 Feet, that we just played, he's on that. So he played the live trombone on that.
Dope.
And Righteous, the song we're going to play, he played the trombone on that. So, yeah.
Like jazzy.
Yep, the jazz feel. Get the live feel. And I haven't really did that with music, with hip hop yet. So doing that is like awesome.
That's
so,
that new energy, that new
what we're
taste,
talking about.
That new,
Hell yeah. So,
time we were like chilling a lot, you had just put out 11.
No way, man.
Yeah, dog. So how many projects have you put out since then? Is this, like, what have you, still trying to figure out what happened in that gap? Because I know you went to school, you got certified, and now you're expanding your whole music range.
Yeah,
like,
11s.
Is there a project? Is there projects that I missed and shit?
Yeah, I did Avengers of Sin and P with me and Sincere.
All right, I remember that one.
Okay,
I remember
Infinite
that one.
Intelligence, that was a really, that was like a, I stepped outside of my zone too because I got involved in reading Think and Grow Rich.
Right.
That was around that time.
Yeah.
That was around the time we kind of met, I think. Like, still on, around that time.
Right.
And then 11.
She tried to give me the book too.
Yeah.
And I already had it.
Yeah. I think Infinite Intelligence was after 11. So.
So maybe that was the last.
That was the last one.
Okay.
Yep. That was the last one we probably were together on. And then Mirrors. I dropped Mirrors. That was like a whole new breakthrough for me. We went on tour.
I saw that.
Yep.
I remember that.
Yep.
You were like
that
out of the country
tour,
and you were doing other stuff.
The first tour. We did the More Peace tour and then came back and then recorded The Bottom Line. And then
I didn't hear that one.
Yeah, that was the one before 3 Feet from Gold.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this new one is 3 Feet from Gold, and before that I dropped The Bottom Line. So,
I was probably still like heavy in school, and I wasn't back in the music shit yet. And
how was school, man?
It changed me, man. You know, like I feel like.
Oh, so you graduated?
I graduated.
You did.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I feel like I grew up for sure.
Right.
I feel like I was.
So you know what I mean, then?
Yeah. I feel like I was really still young. Like even though I was old already, I felt like I was really still like.
Yeah.
Young in my mind,
bro.
And like that's a lot of reality, like a lot of like reality checks.
Yeah.
Because I went somewhere nobody knew me, and so
Where'd you go?
UC San Diego.
Okay. I remember that. Yep,
yeah,
I remember you were going
there.
So
coming from like being promoter active, kind of everywhere I go, people know me. To like going somewhere and like I can't even
that
get
helped
people to
though,
show
right?
Yeah.
You had to kind of
humble,
step back.
Humble,
wow,
for sure.
Man, for
I
sure.
feel like I had to rebuild, and that kind of taught me that I could. You know, like it was kind of like.
Hell yes, I agree.
So you have
rebuilding
a crew.
Is
that still a thing? Now since we're talking about rebuilding, I know like sometimes you got to reconfigure.
Yeah, for sure.
And
those,
shit.
You know, forever, you know, we're going to be a family. You know, we're brothers. That's my brothers. Asiatic Rhythms, yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
shout out.
Heck yeah, shout out to Asiatic Rhythms for sure. Right now, I think I'm just more focused on my path and just, you know, creating my lane and my content. And building my fan base right now Poetic Force, you know, as an artist and as a producer, and just really just trying to grow and rebuild. But we're still connected. Me and Funk Logic got some songs in the works. So,
nice.
Yeah, man. Yeah. You know, it's just I'm just focused on new things.
Yeah.
You know what
it's
I mean?
Good, man. I mean, it's just it's growth. You know, like it happens like over
for
time.
Sure,
you gotta,
for sure.
You gotta go different ways.
Yeah, for sure.
I kind of want to get into. Sacrifices, like hard choices and stuff, because I know that's what it takes to be to do this.
Let's
you know,
go,
like I'm
man.
Pretty sure, like to go on tour and to like finish school. Like
yes,
I mean,
bro.
There's probably a reason why we weren't seeing a lot of each other for a long time because you were like going deep into this path, and you dropped what I think you said like 4 projects.
Yeah,
so
4 to 5.
So that's like obviously a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of
content.
Things that you're not doing.
Yep.
You're not doing other stuff. So like. I want to kind of like get that experience for maybe the people that are listening who don't know you or your struggle, or that maybe they want to do this too, and they
sacrifices.
They gotta hear the hard shit, you know.
Man, you sacrifice a lot too, bro.
I mean,
you
that's why I know. That's why I bring it up, you know, because I like to know. I like
to
hear the struggle part.
Yeah,
of it.
Sacrifice is huge. I actually talk a lot about that in my songs. I sacrifice a lot too, man. Like, you know, even sacrificing just a normal life. You know, just having a job and being comfortable, having a wife, getting kids, having a family, and just living.
Trying to buy a house, trying to have a car.
Exactly. You know,
just the day-to-day.
The cycle,
yeah.
And it's easy to get comfortable in. You can easily get trapped in that, you know. But for me and for us, you know, we're dreamers, man. And we have so much energy built up inside of us that we just want to take over the world and help the world and just be better people, you know. So... And in order to do that, you have to sacrifice what, like friends, family, you know, girlfriends, boyfriends, whatever it is, you know, you have to listen to the signs, listen to the universe, listen to God, and he'll put you in the right positions, man. And if you just trust yourself, like, longevity, it will all come together.
And so, you know? Do you make your money off of music right now, or do you have a 9-to-5?
I still got a 9-to-5.
Right,
you know,
okay,
of course,
so you're
bro.
Working double jobs, double shifts.
Man, I got off work, came straight here.
Yeah, okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, yeah, like,
so
I have to pay my
LA
rent.
Traffic.
LA traffic, getting stuck, and I think that's what it makes me a good artist, too, and people could see the hunger, like, and normal people could relate to that.
Right.
Like, hey, I have a job, too. I have a dream to rap. Like, yeah. I could do it, too, then, you know? And
yeah,
it's, like,
yeah,
true.
Yeah.
You can. Like, don't think just because you have a job, you can't do something else. Like, you can't still follow your dream. I use a job as a tool to invest into my dream.
Right.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. To invest into my career. So if you use that as a tool and you use it to get your life together, it's a blessing, you
right.
know what I mean? But I also did have to sacrifice a lot of jobs to get places, to go on tour. I had to, you know, quit, you know,
because they were going to give you,
they were going to fire me,
yeah.
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you do have to sacrifice certain jobs, but again, God will put you in positions in life where it's going to benefit you in the long run, you know, and I think that's just where I'm at right now. With that, you know what
I feel
mean?
That. So, I feel that.
Yeah, man.
And well, I mean, I bring it up because I know I saw a clip of another radio show you did where you were talking about the concept 3 feet from goal. And I've seen the meme, like the digger.
The digger, yeah. That's my favorite meme, man.
So,
damn, that was before memes, too.
Yeah,
like,
right? Yeah, yeah. That was like,
school.
it was actually like a cartoon that someone drew.
That's
it was
awesome.
Like one of those like motivational, hang in there type shit.
The guy's
shit.
Happy because
he's
about to get it. And the other guy is sad because he was digging for so long
and
gave up.
Walks
away.
Right.
And this new guy comes and takes his spot, you know?
And
that's happening.
That's what this is. That's what this is about, right?
Right, bro. Man, you already know. Yes.
So what was that song that we heard in the break? What was the name of that track?
That was called 3 Feet. That was my first single off of my latest project, 3 Feet
from Goal. That's the cover. That's the title track.
That's the title track, featuring Funk Logic and Jacob Hearing on the horns and Jalon Abrams on the beat. So, yeah, that was one of my first singles. We shot a video for that in New York City.
Oh, dope.
Yeah, went out there. Me and Funk Logic went out there and got that done. So, yeah, check that out. Title
and do you cover the concept in that?
Yeah,
song?
Pretty
that's,
much. That's, yep. Yeah. It's about just, you know, motivation, sacrifice, and, you know, that fire burning inside of you, man.
Yeah.
You just got to go for it, you know? That's what it's about.
Well, I saw you at the last show you did,
Katie Jakes.
Was dope. Was that the first time you played any of your beats for
people? It was. First time playing my beats, man. That was a trip, but I think that was awesome.
They were good, dog. Not just because I know you, man,
bro.
But
thank
like
you.
Even
thank
like a
you.
Lot of peeps in the crowd were like me and Jelani were like, because we were like, oh,
it's
this
different.
This one makes beats now. Let's
yeah.
see. And you're like, oh, not
thank
bad, you know,
that's
like
tight.
Not bad. Like it's
that's
like
tight.
Especially
that's
for someone
tight.
Just starting and
yeah.
to have that courage to
yeah.
do it.
And I have so many, and I had to get the courage to go out there and just try something new, you know. And yeah, I think I'm gonna keep doing that with some with sets, you know, different places, you know, when I feel it's the right place, right time. Pull out my beat machine and just play a couple beats too, you know, and just show the crowd a different, you know, energy.
What
you
are
know?
You using to produce?
I use Machine Native Instruments.
Okay,
yeah.
So you have
the micro, the beat pads,
and it runs.
I got a keyboard, yep, MIDI. So when I want to play keys and stuff, I use the MIDI controller.
Are you envisioning like doing a live beat set? Because that's what I originally thought you were gonna do.
I
didn't know you were just gonna like aux
play
cord
off the
play.
Laptop.
I was thinking like you're gonna pull out.
Yeah,
because like,
Katie Jakes, I didn't know if I could bring my machine and hook it up, and I didn't do sound check. I missed it. So
right.
I just brought the laptop out. But yes, that's eventually when I get better and more comfortable. You know, in that I will start creating live beats. Live,
like for the purpose to be performing that.
Yep, bring the keyboard out, play.
Got you.
Yep, with the song. Yep.
Yeah, and then
takes practice though.
Of course, everything does, right?
Yeah.
No, but I mean, you're on your way.
Yeah,
like, you obviously do that. You're obviously working hard
for sure.
Because I mean, I've had people send me like beat packs and like. Most
you
of them.
Or no?
I do a little sampling and cutting. Yeah,
that's cool.
I'm more of like I'm more of like that mastermind character. I like to put the right people in the room.
I love that. I was just talking about that on the way here. Excuse me.
Yeah, go for it. Take one, two.
Get your water, people. That is important.
Stay hydrated.
Yeah.
A message from Poetic Force.
Yeah. Cheers.
Salud.
Cheers. Salud. Yes. Well, I was talking about that on the way here. Just getting together in studio sessions and live shows and whatever, and just getting creatives together and just, you know, having people create, you know, like if it's your vision, you know, have somebody else try it and put it together. Like, right. I think that's really, really dope. I want to start trying that too.
I mean, that's kind of where I feel like the most, like, that's where the dynamic comes from.
Word.
Because, like, you toss something out and Word. Then someone gets to toss something
back.
Yeah,
that's
back,
like that's a real producer.
Yeah.
You know, like a Quincy Jones, you know, a Dr. Dre, like, those people, yeah, will put that vision out and have the artist create, you know? That's tight. I love that.
Well, I mean, what I was going to get to, though, is that, like, are you planning to produce for artists and
for
become,
sure.
like,
I would definitely
track
love to
engineer?
Do that. For sure,
next,
for sure.
Is that, like...
Track and engineer, yeah, I could
do that right now.
Yep, for artists, if, you know, so if there are any mixing or engineering, holla at me. I got y'all.
Promo.
Let's go.
You got me shameless with it, bro.
Yeah.
That's what this is for.
Thank you guys, man. So salute at Poetic Force. So yeah. Holla. But yeah, for sure. When I, you know, just grow more and help. Yeah, young artists too that are on the come up. I think I can help people out. You know, get to their sound or help them try to create what they vision or just inspire them to just try it.
Like,
you know?
People that are open to work,
exactly.
like that are open minded, that exactly. haven't been kind of jaded
yep.
or don't have, they're not too stuck in their
yep.
ways already.
Yep. Yep.
I've been noticing that, like, a lot of young artists are, like, searching for that because mm-hmm. they're really influenced by what they hear and they see.
I know.
And it's like,
and hip hop is so different now.
Right. I mean,
because it's like, it's just, you know, all computerized, you know, it's.
It's like it's almost like a music that it's like it's made for the algorithm, you know? Like,
wow. Algorithm.
That's
a whole new conversation, huh?
Yeah, I don't know. We only have 20 minutes. I don't know if we can get into it, but no. But I
no,
that's
really.
What
do you think, though? Yeah.
I mean, well,
because it's true. Music for algorithms, like we're
the fucking it's an AI that reads the beat
yeah.
and it the BPM and
yeah.
it's looking at the waves and
Word.
It's kind of like. Oh, this matches. This goes with these
you
people
could,
over
you could
here.
Draw it out. And,
yeah. This music belongs with this other music, and then eventually, like, it's not perfect, right? Like, if you listen to Spotify or any of these things long enough, you're gonna get to some weird place where you're not even into the music anymore because it's just like connecting dots.
And it'll just keep going.
Yeah.
Like, if you don't stop it,
until you end up somewhere with whoever's paying to be on that spotlight
true,
sponsored playlist thing.
Wow.
But I feel like a lot of young artists. I mean, I've worked with some cats that are, like, they start off and they're really, like, on that trap and lean. They want to talk about the drugs and even, like, their social medias like that.
Yeah.
And then they do a couple songs mm-hmm. and they start performing and mm-hmm. then they're like, oh, like, what else is there? Because I can't keep making this same
trap
song
songs,
about
yep.
this same thing.
Wow.
And it's like it happened quick, I feel like, where
they
were
like. I think you can, too, like, because that's what the radio is all about.
Right.
You know, it's like the same thing over and over and. That's true because artists probably think that's what they don't want to hear. You know, they want to talk about drugs and girls. So, hey, I want to do the same thing. But
and hopefully someone hears me and
right?
I get to be in that position.
Instead of just being yourself. Like,
right.
But then
once you start trying to rock in front of people and you don't believe the shit you're saying or like people are not.
It's a gimmick.
Or people are not responding to you because they don't see the authenticity, right? It's like you can't fake it when you're in a room with someone, you know, like when you're in that live performance.
I hear that, bro.
So I just feel like, the music. Online for the algorithm, but like if you're gonna be like converting real people in real time into
get
fans, you're gonna have to like
you're
gonna have to really own your shit.
Yep.
And that's what I like about you is like I believe you. You know,
word,
when I hear
bro.
Your word, like when I hear you rap and I see you perform, I'm like that's that fool. That's
you
who
too,
he is.
Though. You too though.
Yeah.
You do the same
well,
thing.
Real
man.
Recognize real
yeah,
man.
Bro,
you know what
you,
I'm saying? So.
I was just you know when you performed that, now I was like, man, you have a lot of just passion, bro. Like you just. We'll run to the back of the room, make sure it's mixed cool, come back, rap, come back and DJ and come back and make sure, like, still live, like... I love that about you, bro. Like, I mean, that's really
just,
cool. So
that's
I feed off that.
That's necessity, though. I don't want to do that
because
all the
I'm
time,
off next, and I'm coming on next. I'm like, okay, I gotta top that and get to where you're at with that energy, because people in between they do have that. It's like you don't really feel them, huh?
Right.
Like what they're saying, and what.
Because I've even heard fools that have like sick ass bars, like they're putting together complex rhymes, but their delivery is just like, you're like, that shit would be hard if you made me believe what you're saying, you know?
Yeah, and that goes back to saying, like, becoming a producer, you know what I mean? Like helping somebody with their delivery,
right?
You know, like, that's producing, I think, is awesome. Like, I would love to do that. Wouldn't you, like...
I mean, I'm blessed that I've been able to help people do that. You know, I'm not the best at it. Like, I still have someone who tells me, like, "Yo, you gotta bring it. You gotta bring it harder right here." Like,
that's what keeps you going.
Like, your voice is not that tone is not right. Like, let's find that. You know, I still
need
that.
And then you can pass that on to somebody else.
I'm learning and passing on each one, teach one. You know.
Yep, I love that, bro.
So, do you feel like in this day and age, like, because like we said, hip hop's different, music's different, like. You even talked about having to develop your style and start singing and go out of your comfort zone. Like, is that necessary today? Like,
can you just be about that?
It's just a table. I don't know. We'll fix it. It's cool. We're all a work in progress. In here,
is it necessary
to do all that? Like, can you just be a rapper with bars these days, or do you have to be some type of producer and engineer? Like, do you have to have be more educated on the process in order to like really stand out,
that's
or do you think
question.
People could just bar out like, and that's all that they all they
that's
do
all
is rap,
sense, yeah.
and that, that's all they, that's all they do. Do you think like that's still compatible?
I think, yeah. I mean, I think if you just do you, and you're good at it, and you just keep at it. I mean, yeah. I think you could be good off of that. That's who you will be. Known for,
right?
You know what I mean? Like,
like,
oh, you're the MC.
Lane,
you create your lane. But I think as artists, we said that before. Like, we get too comfortable and lazy, and we feel like, you know, we have to do something new. Like, 'cause you're hungry to do something else.
Right.
You know what I mean? So. Yeah, and I also do. I'm a Libra, man. I'm always gonna be like that.
Like, yes and no.
Yeah, but then yes and yes, but
right.
Yeah, I think it is also maybe important to try that, because people are gonna get bored,
right.
You know, and I get bored, and you know the same thing. So it is good to try new things for sure.
I look at it more like from a. Like a value observation, like in today's economy, to be a high value artist, like the rapper, producer, engineer, who also DJs and knows how to do sound and can do lights, is more valuable than the fucking
bar.
The guy who, like, the hype man who just raps, you know, like, at least like. Not always, right?
I feel you.
Because there's people that,
also,
like you said, will cut through with their, because they're that skilled and they actually work on their craft and they go hard.
And they'll grow.
Right, but it's just like when you're trying to sell yourself to these fucking machines of like either.
Yeah, because I was going to say that. Even if like in this day and age too, like you don't even, man, it's trippy. Like some people don't even have to have like good rap skills, but if their social media skills is really good, like. They could blow up. You know,
right.
Like, ain't that a trip? Like, if
it's
if,
a whole new like skill that you have to have.
Word.
Like
you know,
like,
what
we're
saying?
Having to learn that.
Yeah.
To catch
and like the new
that
kids.
Were born in it.
Yeah, the new kids are so good at it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, dude, if my music's good, but then it's like, well, how many followers you got? Oh, you got 2,000? Like, I ain't gonna take your music seriously anymore, and that sucks.
Right.
But it's like, I'm like, dang. If I could just know what these kids are doing
and have like the 28K,
and
then people be
and
like,
plus
okay.
My music is good,
right?
You know, so it's funny. Like, if you're good at social media and if you know how to work Instagram, then you can blow up
like
off that.
Hype
it
like
up.
The next, like my next guest for next week, A Money. Shout out A Money.
Shout out A Money. What up?
He just got on World Star for taking a dab out of the his truck of his fucking skateboard. Like, he took a fucking dab
on
like,
Instagram.
And that shit got
on Worldstar.
Yeah, it got on Worldstar. Wow. It got like 12 wow. million, whatever the fuck, wow. how many fucking hundreds of millions of views.
Wow, bro.
And he's like, 2019 is my year. And I was like, I'm going to get this fool on. And I'm going to ask him, like, wow. did you pay for that?
Yeah.
Because you could, right?
I've talked to Worldstar Hip Hop about, you know, submitting videos and stuff. But yeah, of course, there's a price. And if you have, again, if you have the money,
there's no obstacles at that point.
At all, bro.
But who does?
Right.
Unless you have, like, if the backing of this or the corporate, or you have the label, or mm-hmm. someone believes in you.
I've always said that, too, man. I feel like a lot of the industry is, like, people are already born into it, you know, like
someone's dad,
their dad
cousin,
is Quincy
sister.
Jones,
you know.
Or their cousin is, yep,
or they Kanye, went to school with all the other
kids. you don't realize that, you know, like you're like, damn, this guy made it until like years after, and it's like, man,
you read his bio and you're like, oh yeah, he grew up hanging out with these fools,
my dad worked
at this studio, dude, and like just called you up to
crazy,
come through,
bro.
Like,
yeah. So it's like a lot of people I've scene is like that, you know, but respect on that too. I mean, I'm not knocking
anybody. You leverage your networks,
man.
You know,
yeah,
you
man.
Got that's
like,
I would just
be blessed to have something like that,
right.
You know, but unfortunately my mom and dad were middle class parents trying to just make a living and feed their kids, you know, and my mom couldn't give me a lot of money to follow my dream, you know, like she was just making sure I could freaking get out the house and support myself.
Right.
You know,
there were priorities.
Yeah, man.
But I feel like the harder you work and the more people you connect to, mm-hmm. you're gonna plug in to that network.
What's up, man?
That's how it is now. And I feel like people move differently, right?
Yeah.
Like you could do the whole like, let me fucking do 100 shows, like the uh-huh. Verbs way. Let me do 300
wow.
shows in a year.
Wow.
Or you could do the, let me try, like, my homie, like, 5'8", J26, who's like, let me see if I can get my track.
Shout out to him.
Yeah,
man.
Right? That's
yeah.
dope. I think he lives over on your side, too.
Yeah, that's his side. I'm on his side. I'm from the cold, man. I'm just kidding. Nah, not like that. But he actually just recently, like, you know, like, started supporting me, too, like, liking my stuff. And so that's what's up, man. I think people in the community need to...
Yeah,
help each other and support each other. And,
we just
you know,
talked on Friday. He's actually
is he from Montebello? I'm sorry.
I think he's from West Covina.
Oh, okay. My bad.
Maybe not
I thought
from West
he was
Covina,
from Montebello. That's why I said that.
Living in West Covina right
oh,
now.
Oh, okay. That's what's up. Heck yeah.
You know
man.
What? I always
is Montebello 626?
Mm-hmm.
No. How should I not know that? No, it ain't 626. 323, man. What am I thinking?
But it's like on the border.
Sorry,
like you can drive. You can drive far enough to, like, hit, like, you know?
Yeah.
You'll have a neighbor who has a 626.
Yeah, I don't, man, it's crazy, too. Like, a lot of people are from the Cove, man. A lot of people are from 626.
Well,
like,
I'm tripping
like,
out,
because
the whole Katie Jakes thing, like, since I got plugged mm-hmm. in with that in July mm-hmm. and all that, like, there's a whole nother, like, ecosystem out there. Like, I had you, Jelani, Josiah, like, all these West Cove folks, you know?
Shout
like,
out to TZ Wanda, 626. I don't know if you heard of him.
Don't
coming
connect
up.
Me, dog. This
yep, Jansport J. You know, from the 626.
Okay, I heard of that.
Trek Life. Yep. So,
a lot of peeps.
A lot of people, man. I mean, we're all making noise out here, so we're all from the same place. And
trying to go to the same places.
Go up. Man, that's what's up. I hear that.
All right, man. We have like 5 more minutes left. I want you to shout out all your social media, website. Oh, 7 minutes? Even better. Website, whatever. However you want people to connect to you, whatever you
yeah.
And then talk about this song, Righteous.
For
and
sure.
And then we'll go out like that.
Yeah. You guys could contact me at Poetic Force. Poetic is with a K on all social media platforms. I just got a new website out, so you can head over to poeticforce.com. Can I?
Yeah.
Hey.
It's pretty dope, huh?
Yes, I love that. It feels good. It's like I did something, I accomplished something.
and
all my music, man, is on the social media platforms and streaming platforms. So say what's
iTunes,
up.
iTunes, Spotify,
yeah, all of
all
it.
That.
Yep,
you're
all
on,
of
but
it.
You're also on Bandcamp, SoundCloud.
Bandcamp, SoundCloud.
Gots to be, huh?
I also got hard copies if anybody still listens to CDs.
Yeah.
So.
Are you selling merch too, or is this like a
one-off shirt? I got some clothes, 3 feet from gold. Got some shirts out too, so holla at me.
Any shows coming up? Any projects
that
we should know about?
I'm going to be on Breakbeats and Rhymes radio show coming up.
Okay.
In the next couple weeks. And performance shows, I'll be booking that for the next couple months. And I'm just working on new music right now, new beats and new songs, recording new songs. I'm in a zone right now. Like,
you're feeling it, the energy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I've just been writing a lot. And my goal is to, like, record for the next few weeks. And then after that,
seems like you're in your zone a lot.
Drop a song. I try, bro. And, like, drop a song every week.
Okay, yeah.
I'm going to try it, you know?
That, build that hype.
Build that hype. Yeah, because I'm so used to dropping albums.
You can't do that anymore. Like, here's my whole thing. Go check it out. It's like, you got to tease it. You got to get them the 30-second with the video clip. Then you got to give them the video.
Word.
You got to do the pre-orders.
Pre-orders.
Everybody wants to do pre-orders.
I mean, all that. Like, I was just recently blessed to be a part of Illmind Past the Ox tour he had, and he had a lot of upcoming producers at each studio in L.A., Texas, New York. He's just on tour right now.
So everywhere
and,
he went.
Yep, he came to L.A. It's like 25 people sign up, you know, have to invest in it. And with long story short, when I was there, you know, I got to show him some of my music, show him some of my beats, and he actually did tell me that. He said, focus more on just releasing songs and not releasing albums so much, because that one song on that album, people could miss. You know what I mean?
Because it's buried in there.
It's buried. It's number like, 8.
Yeah.
You know?
It's like at the crest.
Yeah.
Of
and
when
they might not
journey,
get to it.
They might not get to it.
Yeah. You know, and I've knew that knowledge before, but I was just,
you got
to
hear it from someone.
Yeah. A good mentor in the game, man. So shout out to Illmind for blessing me with some knowledge. Shout out to Illmind again. That's some gems.
All right, so Righteous, tell us about it.
Yep, so this new song, this new single from my album 3 Feet from Gold is called Righteous, featuring S.A. Martinez from the band 311.
Okay.
Yeah, so have you heard of 311?
Oh, okay.
Let's
I've seen those fools like two times in a year at the two years in a row at the Verizon.
Yep, we were there
every year they do their same. They have the drum solo.
Yep.
I know about
the drum solo, you know.
It was just 311 day, right?
Yep, it was just 311 day. We just checked out a new documentary that they got out.
That's dope.
Yeah, S.A. is on that song. I got to break it down right quick.
We have like a couple minutes.
Let's go.
Go for it.
Had the bottom line ready. Went to a 311 show. I told myself, I'm going to get this to one of the members. I'm going to give this to S.A. Martinez. Saw him after the end of the show. Gave it to him. He freaking follows me on Instagram. Hits me up. Long story short, work. Send him a song. Sends me this hook, man. And we just built a relationship from there.
That's manifest destiny,
for real. So people, man, believe in yourself. Don't ever front. That's staying righteous right there.
Oh, and
so
shout out to 311. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, shout out to 311 and S.A. Martinez.
Go hit it one more time. 311.
For
S.A. Martinez,
helping the dream out, man. So let's go.
All right, cool.
Man, let's go.
And with that, we're going to get out of here right now and play this song, Righteous. Make sure you tune in every Monday night, 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. on the west side of the after party.
Let's go.
Follow Border X. Follow Poetic Force. Come out and visit. Try the new IPAs. And check out this song, Righteous.
Salute, y'all. Thank you.
Wow.
I just wanna live the righteous way and give thanks to all the haters talking, who always told me you could never make a daily fortune off this rapping. Now I'm packing on a steady motion. They're the same ones calling when they see you flourish, talking about how you living, man. I miss the homie. They see you rich now, they really wanna get to know me. The streets is watching and they plotting on your next move. Never will you see me on my best view, bless you. In the life you're living at the bottom, I'm trying to grow and be the greatest. I am stacking commas, counting money for the f**k. I feel like all my problems, all my hustle, classic records, man, you know I got them. And that's the victory, going down in history. Your lack of confidence will leave you down in mystery. They say my time is near, I'm going down the righteous path. We got a fellowship, I'm guaranteed to make it last.
A righteous way around all my problems. I thought it's spring, but I'm feeling autumn. I'm staying up, even at my bottom. I may be lost, but not unconscious. A righteous way around all my problems. I thought it's spring, but I'm feeling autumn. I'm staying up, even at my bottom.
when the devil's calling. Never think about the bull around the world. They try to take you down and run the whole entire world. But that's the problem with these people always giving in. Instead of chasing after dreams and blowing in the wind, hoping for these miracles to happen like committed sins, waiting for that moment where their life can be as rich as them. But is the money gonna truly buy you happiness? And is it only if the fame will make you happiest? There's nothing better when you're selling out and getting glory and such a life so inspired when they tell your story. Cause everybody's on a mission in this f***ing race, who's really trying to make a change up in this f***ing place. I'm all about it, if you're ready we should let it flow. Gotta feel the vibe, it's the only way to let them know.
Around all my problems, I thought it's free.